Thank you. Thank you, Gene. Welcome, everybody, to Card Sharks. Of course, we're here to have a good time, to give away a lot of money. That's the thing that I like to do most. And who knows, somebody may drive out of here with a new Pontiac Fiero GT back there. Lots of exciting prizes in the cards. Let's get started, of course, always by meeting our lovely dealers. Here they come right now. Here comes Susanna Williams and Lacey Pemberton, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Boy, throw those guys some meat, would you, please? Not a vegetarian crowd, ladies.
I think so.
They really like these new outfits we've got on. Are you ready to do it?
Absolutely.
We're going to start off again like we started off yesterday. I think we're starting off with a tiebreaker. So let's get to it right now. Let's meet our card shark. Here comes Jack. Hello, Jack.
Hi, Bill.
Introduce yourself to the folks at home again, sir.
All righty. I'm Jack Ferguson. I'm a government retiree, and I live in the beautiful spa city of Hot Springs, Arkansas.
And they do have hot springs there, right?
They really do.
They do?
Along with the massage.
Along with the massage.
That's worth the price of admission.
That is. That's probably quite enjoyable. Anyway, Jack is our champion, and no mean feat it is. This man has $20,369 cash and driving. How many trips do you have? You got Hawaii?
Tahiti. Hawaii.
Yeah. Two big trips. I think there might be another one in there. I'm not sure. We're going to have to check our list.
But huge color television.
That's right. I know that. Anyway, good luck to you. Hello, Jean.
Hi.
Jean is a professional musician. Am
I
right?
Yes. I play the French horn, and I really enjoy playing around Los Angeles.
You do? Do you play? What kind of groups do you play with?
Oh, I play in brass quintets, quartets, orchestras, live shows, recordings.
Yeah, it's a show business career. Any place there's a check, you're going to show up. Am I right?
Yeah.
Good girl. That's how you make it in this business. You both cut your cards backstage?
We did.
Okay, good luck to both of you. Let me remind everybody about our prize cards. What do we have in the deck today? We've got a Caribbean cruise, which I believe is on Jack's side of the board. That is close to $4,000. Tiebreaker is all set up right now. Susanna's done it. Three-card game, maximum of three questions. First one always to our returning champ. Jack. We surveyed 100 top business executives, and we asked them, were you ever a hippie? How many top executives said at one point in their life they were?
I hope too many of them weren't. I don't like hippies.
Don't like hippies?
No, not really.
Boy, you can turn a good audience into a mob just like that, Jack. You know that? That's what I like about having you around.
Those people look nothing like hippies out there.
How many top business executives do you think were hippies?
Not over 17, Bill.
Not over 17. What do you think, Gene?
I actually think that that's going to be a little bit higher, because all it takes to change a hippie into a businessman is a haircut.
Is a haircut, right. Yeah, absolutely. That's right. So, all right, she's going higher. The actual number of top business executives who were once a hippie is 9. It is not higher, it is lower. Jack. Tell me what you want to do. A 4.
I'll go higher, Bill.
He goes higher than a 4. He's got a king.
I'll go lower, Bill.
Lower than a king for the game, the match, the cruise, and another trip to the money cards.
Yeah!
Happens that quickly. Way to go, Jack. Well, listen, Gene, thank you so much for being here with us. Good luck with your musical career.
Thank you very much.
We've got some lovely party just for
I'm sure you do.
Take care now. Bye-bye. Come on over here, Jack. There he is.
Bill, I'd like to shake your hand.
I think you're pretty used to doing this, Gene. Tell him about his trip.
Okay, Bill. Jack, you've won another cruise. You and a companion will enjoy a Windjammer barefoot cruise. 6 days of casual sailing adventure for two in the exotic Caribbean for both old salts and landlubbers. Furnished by Windjammer Barefoot Cruises, a vacation package worth over $3,900. Congratulations,
terrific.
Jack.
Just terrific. Beautiful. Whoa, what a nice deal. Listen, by the way, I just wanted to tell Jack that Robin Leach just called, and he wants to follow Jack around the world. We're going to be right back right after this commercial message. Jack, our champion again. He knows how to play the money cards. Lacey and Susanna are dealing out those money cards right now. But in addition to all the money he can win in the money cards, we've added a joker to the deck. Anytime it turns up in the money cards, and I know Jack's thinking about this, he will have a shot at winning this brand new car. Gene.
A new Fiero GT Coupe, the car with a sleek new look and even more aggressive attitude. Fiero GT Coupe, only from Pontiac, worth over $15,000.
Thank you, Gene. You gotta love the U's and I's for the car. Now, come up here. Stand next to me, Jack. Don't be nervous. Now, for winning our match, we're going to guarantee you a shot at winning that brand new car because we're going to start you out with an extra joker. And there it is right now. Susanna's holding it for you. Let's get started with the money cards right now. Give Jack $200, please. Jack, let's play these cards, young man.
Here's your base card.
You got a jack. A jack for Jack. $200 on a
150
jack.
Lower.
150 lower than a jack. A five. 350 on a five.
100 higher.
100 higher than a five. A queen. Hey. We've got 450 on a queen.
200 lower.
200 lower than a queen, he says. There it is. Creating that big win. We got 650. Here is a nine. I'm bringing you up to this number right now.
Number three.
Taking number three. We're going to give you an additional $400. You have $1,050 to bet on this card. A two.
The work's up.
He's going all of it. He's going all of it higher. Yo, no win. No win, no loss, a push. We go
no
on
problem.
To the next card. 1,050 on a two.
All of it up.
All of it higher. An eight.
Hey.
100.
Let's go all of it lower.
All of it lower than an eight. You got it.
Hey.
Take a breath. You got it three. You have $4,200. You got to bet at least $2,100.
Does God hate a coward?
Uh-oh, I don't know.
$4,000 higher.
He's going $4,000. We're talking either he's going to end up with $200 or he's going to end up with $8,200. You got it!
Hey!
Wow,
dude,
that's terrific.
Hey, that's
unbelievable. I don't know how he does it. Really works the cards very well. You know what the number is now? $32,477 cash and prizes. Joker, car, come on back. He's going to do it. And now, you know, it's interesting to me, you know, Jack, I think this is the third trip to the money cards, am I right? Third trip to the money cards? Fourth trip to the money cards, right? I don't know whether Jack wins to win the money or to kiss Lacey and Susanna. I mean, that's the idea what this goes down. Anyway, I think you're right.
Winner either way.
All right, now let's go to this car thing right now. Let's see if we can give you a car. Here is your joker right now. Susanna's holding it. You hold it in your hands. Let me tell you how to do it. In front of you are seven numbered cards. Behind one of them is the word car. If you find it, you're going to get that brand new Fiero GT.
I know this time, man. I know.
Oh.
You know.
You know it. Now, is this hunch, or do you have a special reason?
Gut feeling.
Just a gut feeling. We're looking for the word car. No! No! So, where was it? Oh, no. You know where it was?
Not here.
Yes, not here. Number seven.
Again?
Number seven. That's right, again. Anyway, Jack, you're just such a good
problem.
Player. You could
no
be
problem.
Back here again, but you've got to beat another challenger. She's coming out right now. Go stand over there, sir. Back on your podium. Come on out, Arlene.
Hi, Jack.
Hello, Arlene.
Hi.
Let's hear something about you.
Well, I'm Arlene Gibson. I'm a transplant from the Bronx, and I'm a school counselor with junior high school children.
A school counselor mm-hmm. now here in Los Angeles? How long have you been in the Los Angeles?
12 years.
12 years. Oh, so you're really a native. You're,
no
you're,
more accent.
You're at home now. Okay. You've already cut your cards backstage?
Yes, I have.
Good for you. And let's find out what we have right now. We've got our prize cards we've added. Ooh, this is really nice. Jack, I don't know if you'll ever be home if you win this. There's an Alaskan cruise in there worth $3,600. A Quasar 26-inch color TV. Lots of goodies going on right now. And we're starting out with our audience poll question. And this question involves 10 men who are professional models. They're with us this week. Come on up, folks. Yes. Handsome guys. Always, first question goes to the champ. Last week, we had a group of 10 Playboy bunnies in our audience. And we ask them if they would be a centerfold in Playboy. Turnabout is fair play, so before the show, we ask these 10 male models, would you pose nude for Playgirl magazine? How many of these 10 models said they would pose nude for Playgirl?
I saw those gorgeous Playgirls, or whatever, that you know.
Well, that's what some people called them that, but they were actually Playboy bunnies. That's
Playboy bunnies, okay. But I believe there's more modesty in the male sex. I think maybe five of them would pose.
You think maybe five?
Mm-hmm.
You know, Jack, you're getting to be, you got a lot of money now. You're a popular figure. Would you pose?
not for what I've won, no.
All right, you're going five. What do you think, Arlene, higher or lower?
I hope that more of them would pose, because I'd buy all those magazines. They are gorgeous. I'm going to go higher.
You're going higher than five. This is like waving raw meat at a lion with these ladies here, I'll tell you that. The actual number of these models who would pose nude for Playgirl is 2. It is not higher, it is lower. For purposes of research only, gentlemen, why do I have a feeling I know who one of these guys is right now? Who are the two guys who would pose? Oh, I was wrong. We've got Trenton and Tom. Trenton, since you're dad, you're closer to the microphone, Trenton. You'd do it.
Sure. Always use the additional exposure.
You could
always,
yeah. Sit down. Sit down, gentlemen. Thank you very much. Here we go. All right, Jack. Here's a 4.
That's a good card, Bill.
He goes higher than a 4. He's got a 5.
I'll go higher, Bill.
He goes higher than a 5. He's got a king.
I'll go lower, Bill.
This is getting old. He's going lower. He's got a 9.
I'll freeze, Bill.
Freezes on the 9. Interesting. Interesting. All right, he freezes on the 9, and he keeps Arlene away from the cards. We go to our next question. Arlene, educated guess. Got to think a little bit here. During normal working hours, how many telephone operators are on duty at the White House?
They field a lot of calls, and I think that they probably need a great many people. And I think that their normal working hours are 24 hours a day, and they have one crew for an 8-hour day. I'm going to say about 160.
It's got to be. Okay, we had a clarification from our judges in the booth, and okay. It has to be 99 or lower.
All right, 87.
87.
Pretty big.
What do you think? Hey, it's a big house.
No.
I don't know. Jack, what do you think?
Out of those 87, I'm sure that Nancy needs quite a few of them. But I'm going to go a little lower than that, Bill.
You're going to go a little lower. The actual number of operators at the White House is 20. It is lower. It is 20. All right, Jack.
Change that 9, Bill.
Changes the 9 right now. The 9 now becomes a 5.
Hey, let's go up. Let's go up.
He goes higher than a 5 for game number 1. Very good, Jack. Very good. Jack, again, our champ has won one game. He's got one game on his side of the board. First contestant to win 2, they win the match. And, of course, they get a shot at that brand-new car that's right over my shoulder over there, that Pontiac Fiero GT. Susanna is going to be dealing out the cards now for game number 2. Let's get started right now. Arlene, I got to remind you, you got to jump in here and win this game. Otherwise, it is the land of parting gifts for you, Arlene. You are gone. So, Jack, here it is. First question goes to you, sir. We surveyed 100 psychiatrists, and we asked them, generally speaking, is it okay for an adult to sleep with a stuffed animal? Well, I think it's okay if you don't get involved, really. I mean, I don't think it's good. I want my daddy. How many psychiatrists said it is okay for an adult to sleep with a stuffed animal?
Bill, I know we have a lot of loonies out here amongst us. Are these animals inflated?
Bill. I'll be right out, darling. I'm blowing up a friend.
What is... These educated how do you pronounce that?
Psychiatrist.
There you go, psychiatrist.
Generally speaking, is it okay for an adult to sleep with a stuffed animal? How many psychiatrists said it is okay for an adult to sleep with a stuffed animal?
If it's over 17, I'm going to shoot me. Not over 17 would say that.
Okay, you're going with 17?
17.
Arlene, what do you think?
I don't think there's anything wrong with sleeping with a stuffed animal, and I think psychiatrists would think that's perfectly okay.
You go. Okay.
And I'll go higher than that.
You're going, how many psychiatrists? Okay, you're going higher than 17.
Yes.
The actual number of psychiatrists said, okay, for an adult to sleep with a stuffed animal is 76.
All right. Hey. All right.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, Arlene.
Okay.
Take a look at it. You got an 8.
Lower.
Lower than an 8. We've got a 10.
Lower.
Lower than a 10. We've got a Jack. Ooh. So, Jack, you get a free shot at the cards right now. you're playing from this card, which is a 10.
I'll go lower, Bill.
He goes lower than a 10. He's got the color TV. That goes on his side of the board. Here comes Lacey to put that over there for Jack. Now.
Lower, Bill.
Lower than a 10, he says. We've got a 9.
Lower, Bill.
He continues on. He goes lower than a 9 with a 7.
Freeze, Bill.
Freezes on the 7. All right. Jack freezes on the 7 right now, and we will be back with another question and more card sharks right after this. We're in the middle of the second game right now. Must-win situation for Arlene. She's got to get to the cards and do some damage right now. And here we go with our audience poll question. We have 10 gentlemen with us who are professional models. Come on up, fellas. Here we go. This is for you, Arlene. Before the show, we asked these 10 male models, has a woman ever proposed marriage to you? How many of these 10 models said a woman has proposed to them?
They look awfully young. I don't know if women are ready to propose to them yet, if they want to marry so young. But I think probably around 4 of them have had marriage proposals.
Yeah, 4? What do you think, Jack? Higher or lower?
They're a handsome group, Bill. And these girls are getting bolder all the time. Oh, I believe that's a little higher.
You're going to a little bit higher. All right. So, the actual number of these models who said a woman has proposed to them is 4. It is right on the button. Right on the button. So that means you realize, of course, that for getting it right on the dollar, you get $100. That's for you, Arlene.
Thank
so
you.
You got a little pocket money now. Who were the 4 guys who were that lucky? Who had proposals? Let me see your hand. There are Robert. Robert's in there. It's good to see. Ken, Dave? Dave is all the way over on the end down here with the blue shirt. Dave, how did this situation occur?
Well, I'd asked her first, and she said no, and then 2 weeks later, she asked me. But I'd bought a car in between that time, and I...
it wouldn't work out.
What a hopeless romantic, isn't he, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you very much. Have a seat, folks. What a car. I bought a car, man. I can't get married. All right, Arlene, you got a good car.
Try this lower.
Lower than an ace, you've got a 3.
Higher.
Higher than a 3. She's got the golf club. She's got golf clubs. That's a prize that goes on Arlene's side of the board right now. Lacey's going to be putting that over there for her. We replace that. Again, we're going higher than
a 3.
Higher than a 3, we've got a king.
Lower.
Lower than a king, we've got a 10.
Lower.
She's got to go for it. She's got to tie it up right now. She's going lower than a 10. No. What a walk.
Really
this is
that.
All the way back to that ace again. And that means that Jack gets a free shot at the card.
I'll try higher 7. One time, Bill.
He goes higher than a 7. He's got a 4. So just about pulled it out of the fire right there. Let's go on right now, Arlene. You were in trouble, but who knows what's going to happen on this next question. Jack, educated guess. How many nuclear reactors are in commercial operation in the United States?
Fourteen,
he says. What do you think, Darlene?
I think there are fewer than that. I think it's lower.
You're going lower than 14. I have no idea. The actual number of functioning nuclear reactors in the United States is 95. It is not lower. It is higher. 95 in operation. That is interesting.
Change it, Bill.
You want to change that 7. 7 now becomes an 8.
Lower, Bill.
Lower than an ace.
Bill.
He's got a 2.
Higher, Bill.
For the game to match the color TV and another trip to the money card.
Congratulations.
Well, Arlene, thank you so much for being here. You got $100, some nice party gifts. You're against a tough player. This guy is dynamite. Come on out here, Jack. Come on,
Jack.
All right, Gene, tell Jack about his prize.
Okay, Bill, Jack, you have won, styled for today's lifestyle, the Delta from Quasar. It's a 26-inch stereo receiver monitor in high-tech, Euro-style cabinetry. Congratulations, Jack.
Thank you very much, Gene. That's 2 color TVs this guy's got right now, in addition to cruises and money and everything. Who knows what's going to happen when we come back and he goes to the money cards. We'll see you then. Out of time, as always. We don't have enough time. When we start tomorrow's show, Jack's going to go to the money cards. He's going to try and win that new Pontiac again. This guy is so busy and so lucky. Tune in tomorrow and see what happens. We will see you then on Card Sharks. Bye-bye.